Yes, so good morning my people, good morning, welcome to my channel. If this is your first time out there, don't forget to subscribe, click the notification button, share and comment on our video. And as you do so, God bless you all. Quickly, I'm quickly bring you this latest album news when you come out. So, you know, I'm not much color here about this matter of this guy, Pastor David. You know, they accused of the map, Pastor David, so many, many things. You gotta come and get contact, say, to leave my pastor dog through other made a freeze in your account. You know, and I would touch and say, man, in get many secret things when we say in do when the Omega Fire Ministry under the auspices of apostle. Say if the apostle know that made the release in account, in bank account, in go talk many things when we say whenever we hear, whenever we know. You know. This is should have become not a go beyond boundary. For me, I think it's enough of this whole thing. You know, even on these guys, you talk to these guys, you like, they should calm down because all these activities now, they affect Christianity. You know, they affect Christians who are faith. Whether or not truth or not be true, I don't know. I don't really know. But the fact is that as he's doing this, you know that the name Christianity is being brought to the mud. We get Muslim, we get everybody who believers, unbelievers, who say they don't have glory to Christ, Muslim men. They wouldn't think of glory to Christ. If they see all these things right now, they are being discouraged. You understand? And most of all, most Christians, all true apostles, you know, give their life to Christ. If they can't accept this kind of thing, especially those ones who say, they come up as Christians, their faith will be, you know, challenged. So I want to beg this guy, Pastor David, whoever knows him or anybody can share this video to him, he should please let peace reign. He should please, as he claims to be a man of God, he should know, he should have the fear of God in him. Let God be the judge of this whole thing. You understand? Whether it's right or it's wrong, I don't really know, but please, enough is enough. Enough is enough for the sake of Christianity, for the cross of Christians, and for the sake of Christ, whom we are all serving, for the sake of heaven. He should let bygone be bygone. Let him leave everything for God to judge. Thank you very much. If for those of us who never see the video, I will quickly play the video for now. We cannot see one in the talk, say, in the threatening apostle, they talk many things. Okay, don't forget, before you leave this channel, if you don't subscribe, please endeavor to subscribe, you know, follow us, get notified, and get updated. Thank you very much.
Well, good evening, everyone from in Nigeria and from around the world. My name is Mike Davids. My attention has been drawn to a video that was made by Apostle John C. Suleiman 24 hours after my audio was released. And that video that he made addresses two major things principally, which I'm going to respond to right about now. The first one is that he claims that I was never the one he was addressing in that video, in that audio, and that that audio, the conversation as it were, was made 3 years ago. And secondly, he claims that he sent me out of Omega Fire Ministries, you know, for reasons of blackmailing other pastors and what you have. So I'm going to respond to them very quickly. First is that the audio I released is the original audio, and Apostle John C. Suleiman knows as much as I do that audio is the original audio. The one he released is doctored, fake, manipulated. Don't forget that I was part of that system for 16 years. And, you know, this is all part of the system. All of these manipulations and all of the gimmicks that goes on, you know, behind the scenes. We all know how these things play out. All right? So don't even go there. You all right? Because all those ones you are releasing is a lie from the pit of hell that, you know, it was some persons you were addressing and all of that. Then two, that you sent me out of Omega Fire Ministries for reasons of blackmailing, you know, pastors. I was never in that habit. Now, I want Nigerians to know and everyone around the world that it is a lie. I left that ministry because I became very convinced that weakness is never the same as wickedness. And it became very obvious to me that my eternal destiny was not in view following the kind of leader, you know, that I was following. And that if I continued in that ministry, I knew where I was going to end. All right? So I left of my own free will. You were never the one that sent me out of that ministry. I was tired of your ungodliness as a leader, and that was the major reasons I left that ministry. All right? So to forget all those manipulations and all those cheap lies that you are trying to buy Nigeria with. They already know the truth for themselves. You get what I'm saying? Then secondly is, we all know the part I played in Stephanie Otubo's saga. You know as much as I do, all right? How much involved I was in bringing that issue, that saga to a halt. All the traveling to Sapele, I was part of that privileged team that was dispatched to Sapele, you know, that was managed by, you know, a crisis communication expert known by almost everybody. All right, I don't even need to mention name. You know me as much as I do, and you knew how we got Stephanie Otubo to come to the altar and apologize to Mama, and brought to Stephanie Otubo's mother to Auchi. Are you get what I'm saying? I'm coming to that issue, all right? Because you are pushing me real hard. I'm coming to that issue because I'm sure that the world and Nigerians will be interested to know how Stephanie Otubo eventually came to Auchi to make that confession the day she actually did. They want to know what really happened. All right? So Apostle Joseph Lema, you know as much as I do that we both knew what happened. I will come to that. All right? Then thirdly is that as far as I'm concerned, I'm also aware that a lien has been placed on my account. All right? Well, probably through your agents and those that you are using, who I don't know who they are. You have released policemen after me, looking for me everywhere to get me arrested and all of that. You are supposed to be a man of God. All right? And I don't know why you are releasing the police against me. And I don't know why they would have my account freezed so that I would have no access to funds and all of that. So I want everyone around the world to be aware of what is going on. Presently, as I speak to you, my account has been freezed, which is not a problem. And I want you to know, Apostle John Suleiman, that despite all you are doing, you are oppressing, manipulating, and all of that, threatening my mom. I've received informations of the people you are sending to my mom to threaten the poor woman and all of that. Let me tell you, I am not perturbed. All of this doesn't move me at all. As a matter of fact, they are getting me stronger by the day. Apostle John Suleiman, let me advise you, as a leader that you claim you are, you have 48 hours to instruct those who have a hand in the blocking of my bank accounts to undo whatever they have done. If they don't, you will not like what is going to follow. Don't say I didn't give this warning, because you are pushing me very hard. Are you getting what I'm saying? And as far as I am concerned, I don't want the body of Christ to be dragged longer than necessary than it already had. All right? So these are just a few responses I have to the video that Apostle Johnson Suleiman have done. I leave you all to be the judge of whatever it is that is happening. Apostle Johnson Suleiman, don't forget, we'll meet in court.